This week's episode is brought to you by Hard Mike's Lemonade. Hard Mike's Lemonade tastes like urine, is urine. Tonight, on Prison and Politics, Canada's naval procurement scandal continues. Is Steve from Cell Block D overcharging to smuggle things in his belly button? And is it time to abolish the death penalty for looking funny at 8-Ball Chris? But first, are the Latin Kings finally going to get their long-awaited electoral reform? Welcome to the East Toronto Detention Center, and to another episode of Prison and Politics. I am former senator and future member of the National Post editorial board, Ethan Samuelson, and joining me today is electoral reform advocate, Rafael Los Muertos, an outspoken critic of Latin Kings leader El Lobo, and a current dead man walking.
It's my pleasure to spend what may be my last day with you, Ethan.
Let's shank right to the chase here, Rafael. Are we going to see electoral reform anytime soon?
The short answer, no. El Lobos has shown time and time again that he's willing to break campaign promises and legs for the sake of political expedience.
Well, then why promise electoral reform in the first place?
Well, at that time, he probably thought he could count on the Third Party Nation of Islam for support. But they run a hard line of proportional representation, and, well, the Aryan Nation, they'll never support anything the Latin Kings do.
No, you know, that is the risk you run when you're a centrist prison gang. You can be outflanked on both sides of the political spectrum.
Political considerations aside, El Lobo does have a preferred electoral system.
Mixed member proportional? Ranked ballot?
Do as El Lobo says, or you die.
It is a simple and easy to understand system that eliminates the need for runoffs. But is the Lobo government going to pay a political price for abandoning electoral reform?
I'd be surprised. Outside a handful of liberal enclaves in the prison library, the general public just doesn't seem to care.
Well, it's a fascinating take. Thank you, Rafael.
No, thank you. Can you help tape these to my body, please?
Well, that's all the time we have this week. But tune in next week for our solitary confinement election coverage. Will the incumbent candidate get reelected, or will he be taken down by the plucky underdog himself?